Hi, this is MC Jetty for a new series about automation. This is a tutorial series for RFTools, RFTools Control and XNet, and it focuses on everything related to automating items, fluids, power, and also on automation control and information. So these last two about how to, for example, how can you see how much power is left in your base and so on. So that's basically the focus of this tutorial. This will be a multi-part tutorial because these three mods that I just mentioned actually have a lot to cover. So I will start with the basics, which are these logic blocks. I will go over them one by one. So. And I should probably go too peaceful because it gets too crowded here. Like that. So basically, with these blocks, these are the basic tools that you can use for automation. So let's go over them. The first one is the sensor. Sensor is a pretty easy block. Oh yeah, one thing about all these blocks, to place them, I often see people having trouble with the orientation of them. Where does the output go? But it's actually pretty easy. What I often see people is putting them down and then taking wrench to rotate them, but that's not needed. If I want the orange arrow to go to the right, I can do that easily. It just depends on where you click on this block. Also, if you place them on the wall, to the right, up, down. So it's the side where the redstone output goes that will be at the position that you click. So in case of the sensor, this is the redstone output, so let's put a lamp there. And then you have to say in the user interface what type of sensor you want. So the default is block, so this will detect one block in this given area in front of the sensor. So if I put something there, yeah, it will detect it. You can increase the area, for example, 5 blocks, so it will go up to here but not here. It's too far. It also has a 3x3 possibility, so we need to detect here, for example, 5x5, 7x7, or just 1. You can say all, for example. If you say all and 3, it means all have to be there before the sensor goes on. So that's the possibilities with block. Fluid is the same. You can also say, for example, with block you could also, let me test that. But let's just pick a block like this and put it in here. So this works, but if I put this one there, I suppose, oh, it also works. But not this one, so it doesn't. Yeah, this is these are actually the same block, just another variant. But this doesn't have find control, so it just says you have a block, but nothing more. A block of a given type without NBT or metadata. So fluid was the next. You can place a bucket there to detect the fluid, so that's also a possibility. Growth. So that's a growth level, so let's try it out. Set area 1. By the way, you can shift click to go backwards in these kinds of things, or right click works as well. Not many people know that. So let's shovel. No. Not a shovel, a hoe, of course. And let's put in some water. Like that. And seeds. Okay, so we set level to 2. And bone meal. Voila, it works. So you can detect how much your crop has grown. Okay. Next one is entities. So let's pick a bigger area. Yeah, it detects me, so I'm an entity. It also detects this kind of entity. Or so any kind of entity in this area will be detected. You can specify if there are more than a certain number, say 10, and that's 5 by 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, you have to be careful with these because they clump together. To add a few different types here. Yeah, now it works, and it will stop emitting soon as some of them are picked up. Players is purely for player detection. So the area it detects, let's pick a smaller one. It's exactly these 3x3 blocks. Hostile mobs, passive mobs, and back to block. So that's the sensor. Can be used for various things. It's pretty useful block if you know what to do with it, especially the growth and the entity detectors. For the next block in the tutorial, I set up a simple storage system. Explaining this is beyond the scope of this tutorial, but basically, I have another tutorial for this. There are different inventories, a chest with some random stuff, 2 storage cubes from Ariente, and 2 modular storages. This one's empty. And with this device, you can access all of this at once. So the reason I want to have this is because there's a level limiter which works specifically to automate. If you have a big storage system, you can use this to count a certain item in your storage. So if you place it down, it needs a storage control screen module first. And that's this guy. We link it by sneaking and right clicking. I mean, insert it here. And then, so that's the module. let's say we want to count iron ingots. So let's pick one. First, you can already see the tooltip how much it has. One extra, and then you can set, yeah, rootable means all these with a star, and or dict ignore or use, and it also gives out a red sort signal if there are more than that number. So say you set it to 1000, all done. Oh yeah. Great, let me go back. Yeah. Oh, I lost. So 1000 is, yeah, now it's on. 10, 100, thousands. Okay, so it works. So this can be useful specifically if you have storage scanner and you want to keep track of some item and set redstone signal if the number is exceeded. That's basically what this guy does. So now let's go to some of the other logic blocks. The timer. This is a very simple block which sends out redstone pulse every second in this case. You can change this. And it also has an input. Basically, by default, the input will just reset the timer so that nothing happens. But you can also make it so that this will just pause and then it will go on. So if you need some kind of signal that is repeating, you can use this. That's the timer, it's very simple. Even more simple than the timer is the wire. That doesn't have much functionality, but I show you. It just acts like a normal redstone block, except it has less lag. This causes block updates, well this one too, of course in this case it doesn't matter. But the wire is more efficient, and it the redstone level will not go down. It can count two bends, it's a really limited block, but you can place it on ceilings like this, on walls like this. So that's easy. Another block, which is kind of fun, but let me quickly set up a wall for this. So there's also the digit, which is this one, and it basically measures how much the strength of the redstone signal, and it displays it. This is the F, it's a hexadecimal number, because yeah, you can in one digit you can only go up to 9. So it works like that. It is say I have redstone signal here. Yeah, you see it is 1 down, this is 15, 14, and this is E, which represents 14. Let's go even further. Yeah, it measures 6, so that was the last, you see in the one probe display, that was the last one. You can place all the digits there. This is 8, and this will be 10 or A, like this. So that's the digit. Let's clean up the redstone. Okay. The next block is the analog. This is probably a block that few people know, and it's also maybe it has uses, but it's a bit special. So the analog block has 3 inputs and 1 output, and to demonstrate this, it's probably easiest use this in combination with one of these guys. Let's place this one high. Analog here. So basically what this does is this complicated user interface is actually not that hard, but basically there's an A input and a B input. If A equals B, then this equation is used to calculate the output from the input. So let's get some redstone signal in the input. So 8, because what is happening, A is equal to B, the redstone level at this side is the same as this side. So it will use this equation, and what does it, this equation say? Input times 1 plus 0. So the input and output will be exactly the same. Say I set 3 here, then this is B, so the input is 8 plus 3, 11, and that's hexadecimal B. Let's make the signal a bit weaker. It's somewhat easier to explain. 7, so the input is 4, output is 7. Okay, say you can use also, you can multiply with floating points here. So if A is less than B, then we will half the input. So this is input, this is A, so this is A. Okay, so now this side is more than this side, so this side is more than this side, that's this equation, and we will calculate the half of the input power and set it to the output. So 4, 2. Now it's equal again. So, and if it's the other way around, we will use this equation where we will double the input. You can also decrease this. So basically, it's a bit of a funny block. You can use this in combination with comparators. For example, say you have something measuring power. You have two power banks, for example, and you want to do something when this one is bigger, has more power than that one, then you can do it like this. There are probably lots of applications if you think about it, but it's somewhat harder to set up, to think about uses with this one. Next one is the sequencer, which is actually let's pick these. A pretty funny and powerful block, can be used for all kinds of things. I'm not sure if it will be fast enough. So basically, what does this do, sequencer? It can do a lot of things. You have a sequence of 64 bits, and you can control, for example, the pattern that you want to use. And then it has different modes. So let's go over them. When a redstone signal is received, loop the cycle once, ignore further process. So let's do it. So you see, it highlighted, it sent out power 15 three times based on the sequence. So let's do it again. Yeah, so that's the once one mode. Once two, when a redstone signal is received, loop cycle one, restart if new pulse arrives. So that's basically the same, except that it will restart if a new sequence comes. In contrast with the previous mode, where it would ignore further inputs. Yeah, this is just looping. It will loop the sequence all the time. By the way, if you sneak, the one probe will show where it is, but of course the one probe doesn't refresh every tick, so that's why it doesn't show every tick. You can increase, make it slower. There you see exactly what is happening. So it is going over the sequence one by one. Loop 2 means loop the cycle all the time, but restart on redstone pulse. So it's now there. It has restarted. Loop 3, loop the cycle when redstone signal spread and continue at current step. So this is off, it's not looping. Let's turn it on. So it's looking now. Let's turn it off. It stays where it is. Turn it on again, it continues. So that's loop 3. Loop 4. Loop the signal when redstone signal is present, we start on no signal. So there's a present. That's present, I mean. And now it's restarted. And it will go on again. So that's loop 4. Step. This is one step at a time for every redstone pulse it gets. Like that. And then we are back to square one. If you have a smaller sequence, for example, you want to do only the first 16, you can also do that. And let's just say loop. Yeah, so it will stop here, it will only do this one. And yeah, you can say if the sequence ends in, for example, if you use one of these modes, yeah, it will end in a enabled instead of disabled. And you can invert the pattern and clear it like that. So the sequencer is a pretty powerful block. You can do all kinds of things. It's often used in endogenic power generators as well, because it can very precisely give a sequence of redstone pulses at the right time. There are lots of things you can do with this. So that's the sequencer. So for the next block, I'm also going to install a screen. Make it a bit bigger. That's the counter. The counter is a block. Yeah, it's upside down, but that's okay. Let's put it there. Oh, no, let's put it in. So you set a maximum, 50 for example, and let's get the lever. It counts how many redstone pulses it gets, and when it reaches the maximum, let's decrease the maximum a bit. You can also set the current value here. But this, I can't seem to, yeah, there's a bug there, I can't set it below 1, but 4, 9, yeah, it's upside down the digits, but it's now sending out a signal and it restarted it. So that's the counter, can be used to count. If you set this very high, it will never cycle. The reason I put up a screen is that there's also a module for the screen counter, which is compatible with this redstone. You link it, insert it, and it will show the current value like that. And yeah, you can set all kinds of things there. Let's put the label there. So this you can use, for example, if you have, you want for in combination with that sensor, you have to count how many mobs have triggered the sensors, then you can increase the redstone signal whenever that happens, for example. So that's the counter. So another very useful block, probably one of the most useful, is very similar to this one, but it's not for analog logic, it's for digital logic, and my wall is getting too small. So let's do this on the floor again. So basically, what does this do? It's basically a truth table. You have three inputs, one output, and the output depends on the three inputs. So let's set up a simple case. No, that's output. Input and like that. So let's say there are many things you can do. Let's set three inputs like this. For example, if you just want to replicate the input, which is B, then you set this and this to on and the rest to off. These ones are ignored. It just listens to this one. But if you, for example, want to, if this one is on, then you want to this to be off all the time. So now this signal doesn't do anything. So you can make combinations like this. This is the uses of this block are pretty big. You can do various kinds of things with this. For example, you can have as input the output from some sensor, and then with an on-off switch you can control if that output should go through or not. That's one use. But you can also make memories with this. For example, say that B is the input, so if B is on, you set it to on. And if B is off, you set it to keep. Okay, so on. So now it remembers, but there's no way to reset. So we want to have reset on A. That means that if A is on, so that's our reset. So that means with this device, as soon as a redstone signal comes in, it will remember it forever until you reset it again. So you can use this in combination with a sensor, for example, to detect if at some point a player has been at your doorway, and then you can see that there. So, and reset again. So that's what the keep does. Keep, so this is to set the signal to on, this is to off. And with keep, you just keep the previous value. So what happens here is the B input, if B is on, you set it to on. If B goes off again, you set it to keep, whatever it was. And if A is on, you simply set everything to on. Like this. You can do various things with it. It's all combinations are possible here. It's a pretty flexible block. So you saw earlier this guy, the level emitter. There is actually also let's put that here. An inventory checker, which is similar, but it needs to go in that direction. So that's the sensor side. And it doesn't work with storage scanner, but just with a direct inventory. So now it's just counting. And it takes a specific slot. So not all of it, but just a specific slot. And if there are more than 10 items in that slot, it will enable it to true. But let's do it with a chest. It's easier to check. Yeah, so let's set amount to 10. Yeah, so it works with this slot and this slot only. Say you want to count only bone meal. You can use these as well. So now it's off. And now it's on. So that's the inventory checker. It's a very easy block, easier than the others, but It only works on a single slot in a single inventory. The last two blocks for the redstone logic are the redstone receiver and redstone transmitter for wireless redstone. So let's say we have this one here. We have redstone transmitter. It doesn't have a channel yet, so we link it, sneak right click. Just right click, channel set 1, so the receiver now has channel 1 and this has also channel 1, and then we can put the receiver on the wall and put a digit on top of that, and let's try it out and reset like that. So that's wireless redstone. Very easy. You can have multiple receivers on the same channel, of course. The screen also has an interesting application with that. So oh yeah, I see. Yeah, this tooltip has a bug, which I just noticed because this is my development version. I have refactored a lot of things, so apparently I need to fix that. But basically, what you can do is here, channel 1 off, and if you then turn it on, it goes to on. So you can also monitor these on a screen. You can say analog mode, then it will give a number, and you can set another color. Like that, for example. Redstone enabled, reset it. Yeah. So that's one thing you can do with wireless redstone. What you can also do, there's also a module for this one. And let's say I think I can clear the channel here, yeah, like that. Channel set to 2, so I linked the redstone button with this receiver now, and then insert it in the screen and set to toggle mode, that's easier. So you see, this way you can have redstone, a redstone button to control something. So this integration is useful if you want to remotely turn on or off a certain machine, for example. And that one is useful if you want remotely to be able to see if, for example, if there's a sensor here that detects something, you can monitor the status here. That's for that gives some very interesting applications to monitor and watch what is going on in your base and to control it. So besides, there's also two other blocks I want to show which are useful in combination with all these, and that's the liquid and the RF monitor. So the RF monitor, let's put that one here. Important to note, that's the part where it will measure. And let's put a simple power cell there. Actually, no, that's not the part where it will measure. What am I saying? Let's put it here. And that one here. So the RF monitor is able to monitor something in a 3x3x3 area. You just select it and you set at which point it should increase its set alarm. So here control when redstone signals should be sent, less than 50%, more or off. So let's use less and let's go this way. So you see there's a redstone signal now. Now it will start filling. And the redstone signal goes off because this is more than half full. So this is a very useful block. So the redstone signal comes out here. To use in combination with these blocks and the monitor and so on, it allows you to measure your power situation. Same with the liquid monitor. It's exactly the same, except that it monitors a tank or something. Like say you have the president's tank, then you can monitor it like that. So this concludes this part, which is just basic redstone and sensors and monitors and logic. These are the basics. You can use these in combination. You can already do a lot of things with these. And in the next episodes, we will show you RF2's control and XNet, and how you can also use these in combination with those tools. But that will be for next time. So, see you next time. Bye bye.